Alright, let's get started in our usual standing pose. Parvatasana, just come on your toe, come down on your heels, lift your toe a couple of times. Roll your shoulders. Back and forward. Take it to a back bend. Oh, I think someone needs to me up to that. Let your head hang. We come to ragdoll pose. Step or hop back. Up dog. Down dog. Right leg up. Right leg forward. Come to low lunge. Stay in low lunge. Sorry. Used to this, so it's giving me a little hard time. Anyway, I see my own video, which is problematic. No lunge. Then lift your lunge. Back bend. Lift your back, back heel. Or actually, back knee. Come to warrior three. If you can, extend your arms in warrior three. Then come to warrior two. Actually, not really warrior two. High lunge and have your body in 45 degree angle. Nice. Then go back to plank. Down dog. Left leg up, left leg forward, low lunge. Lift your lunge. Tuck your back toe. And then lift to warrior three. Extend your arms if you can. Then come to warrior, sorry, not warrior two. It's a high lunge, keeping your body in 45 degree. Come back to plank. Down low. Right leg up, right leg forward. Come to warrior three. I don't have space, so I'm gonna keep my hands behind. You can keep it forward. And then come to high lunge. Have your body in 45 degree angle. And then lift. Like, bring your arms up. All right. Again, 45 degree. And then go to warrior three. Again, come to high lunge in 45 degree angle. Lift. Come tilt forward, then come to warrior three again. Then end it with a standing split. Come to plank. No, no.
Left leg up.
Left leg forward. Come to warrior three. Then come to high lunge in 45 degree angle. And then lift your lunge. Then warrior three. Come back again to high lunge. Lift your lunge. Warrior three. Standing split. Come to plank. Down dog. Right leg up. Right leg forward. Come to pyramid pose. Come to an inverted prayer. Chest open. And then forward foot on your leg. Free your arms and come to revolving pyramid. Warrior three again, and then come to revolving, or sorry, is it revolving? Basically half moon, reverse moon or revolving half moon. Then come to plank. Down dog. Left leg up. Forward, pyramid pose. Come to an inverted prayer. Leaning with your chest, fold forward. Free your arms, come to revolving pyramid. Warrior three. And take it to revolving half moon. Come back to plank. Right leg to right arm. Right leg to your wrist. Arm, wrist, three. Four, five. Down dog. Come back to plank. Left leg to left arm to wrist. Two, three, four, five. Look in between your hands. Then from here, put the inverted tabletop. Come back down. And then engage your core, lift one leg, lift the other leg,
And you can repeat that or try lifting both legs.
Join me in all fours. Good, go. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. Breathe out. Breathe in. One side, and maybe you can take it to a half bind. Come back to center, open the other side, and maybe you can take it to a half bind. Alternate leg, alternate hand. I'm gonna do the other side, so I'm gonna move it side to side, so like 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Let's do the other side. Alternate leg, alternate hand. One, two, three, four, five. Come to chest, please. Peoples. Thread your needle. Come to center. Thread your needle. Come back to center. Come to dolphin. And then you can just hop a little bit. And not, I'm gonna avoid doing too rigorous pose just because my elbow would get callous there. So just a reminder to myself whenever I feel safe, I don't want to do that. But yeah, feel free to hop and come through. Pinch Marasana after you're done with that. Come join me in all fours again, except this time. Have your wrist inverted and you can stay here or do this. All right. And then we're gonna try to come to Mayura or Peacock. If you want to avoid it, just stay in all fours. A few things that help is looking forward. And when you put your elbow, try to put it on the side of your core. Like right, not right on your navel, but the side of your navel. Two sides, all right. So when we're in seated, we're gonna take it to some back bend. Ustrasana.
have one thing that I remembered. This is the t-shirt I wore when I came to US. Not for the first time, but I came to US to join my school maybe 12 years ago. Well, actually 11 years ago. Coming back. I think I don't have this card, I donated it. But yeah, this was the t-shirt I was wearing. This one is also due for donation, I think. One more time, we'll stress them. Coming up. Now let's come to Virasan. Coming out from Virasan. Let's go to Half Lotus, Half Lotus. It's always a nice one. Other side. Now let's meet me in Vasistasana. On the other side. Come back to plank. To down dog. Right leg up. Right leg forward. Warrior one. Two. Reverse the warrior. Side angle. Triangle. I'm holding a half bend. You can if you want to. If you want. Half moon. Shavasana. Natarajasana. Standing split. Get some hops or headstand. Back to down dog. Left leg up. Left leg forward. Warrior one. Warrior two. Reverse your warrior. Side angle. Triangle. Half moon. Shavasana. Rajasana. Standing split. Then either some hops or hips. Leg up,
forward, come to an open legged forward fold. Let your head hang. Open your one side and hold a half bind. Open the other side, then half bind. Come lift up to goddess. Come on your one toe, come on the other toe. And then pulse, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Nice. Stretch everything out. And then let's come side to side in side lunge. 1, 2. Side stretch. Coming out. Other side. Forward fold and then side stretch. Nice. Let's come to Malasana. Some bind. Let's try to come to Titi Vasana. If it's in a practice, otherwise stay in Malasana and watch me. So for Titi Vasana, lift your hips, place your palms right behind your heel, and then using that shelf, lift your legs up. Nice. We can do one more time. This time I'll dye my hair so I actually can see forward and not just my hair. So let's do one more time. Tibhasana, for advanced yogi, which I can't do yet, eventually your arms become straight. You don't need the shelf. But I have to admit, I don't need the shelf. Alright. Come to Navasana. Open your feet in bound angle and foot forward. Coming out. Come to double pigeon. And then recline. Coming out, come to Bhumukhasana. Stick your tongue out. And then let's come to Ardhanatsandras. You can bind if you want. Come back to center. And switch your legs to come to double pigeon on the other side. Recline. Kumukhasana on the other side. Stick your tongue out. Then, most fun one, Ardha Matsyendrasana. You can use this as leverage. As you can see, I'm using my thigh on top of my, I'm using my upper arm on top of my thigh. You can bind if you want, but look back. Very nice. Alright, time to hit the ground. Bridge pose. Come back down. Lift your bridge. Come back down. Come to a gentle inversion to shoulders. If you want to try working on your shoulders down a little today, you can let your arms go. Again, this is for slightly advanced yogis, so if you don't feel comfortable, please stay here. Otherwise, when you let your arms go, your neck carries a little bit of weight. And your arms. Alright. From here, come to plow pose. Halasana. Maybe come to left man's pose. Back to plow, and then roll out one vertebra at a time with control. That's nice. Come to Matsyendrasana. Baby, welcome to Savasana. Come to your favorite side on a fetal pose. Lift up in a comfortable seated position. We'll close our practice with a round of warm breathing. All right. Thank you for joining me. See you guys tomorrow.